Hey, Dr. Berg here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get rid of kidney stones. Many years ago, I personally had kidney stones, and I'll never forget how much pain that is. So it's excruciating. So I'm going to show you, first of all, what causes them and then what to do about them. First of all, in the blood, with the chemistry in your body, if it's not right, you can set your body up to build up the crystals of calcium. They're called oxalate stones. It's a combination of oxalates and calcium. So there are other causes, there's other types of stones, but the most common one is the calcium oxalate stones. And that has to do with, in your blood, you have low citrates. And basically, citrates help you prevent kidney stones. They help combine with excess calcium and remove it safely from the body. So if you don't have citrates, what will happen is you'll start to build up more crystals that develop in the tiny little tubules of your kidney and develop stones, okay? And then number two, high oxalate foods. Now, what foods are high oxalate? Number one, dark beer, cruciferous, which I recommend, like kale, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, chocolate, fruit, soy, beans, beets, spinach, and all these are high in oxalate. So the combination of this and this is not good. But then if you're taking antacids, that's a problem, especially if it's calcium based, because you're driving in a lot of calcium into the body that it can't deal with, so it's going to get stuck in the kidney. And that's the soft tissue calcium that builds up. And then calcium itself, calcium supplements. You want to make sure you never consume calcium carbonate in your body. So you want to look at your vitamins and see, is the ingredients calcium carbonate? That's the worst type of calcium. That's like taking rocks. You'd be better off chewing on the cement outside because it's basically just like oyster shells, or it's not something our body can digest easily. There's like 12 steps it takes to be able to assimilate, and for most people it just gets stuck in your kidneys. So we don't recommend taking a lot of calcium. And just as a side note about calcium, if you are menopausal and you're female and you want to prevent osteoporosis, and maybe you have high blood pressure, or you have any type of soft tissue calcium like stiffness, I created a video on that one thing, soft tissue calcium. It's very important. You can click below and find it. It's about vitamin K2. Very important to kind of remove the excess calcium. So we have calcium, which is a whole different topic, and then sugar. Sugar depletes excess calcium, and that can go through the kidney out of the blood and get stuck in your kidney too. So sugar is not a good combination. And then sodium. Now, sodium chloride, that would be salt, but I'm not talking about sea salt. I'm talking about sodium just in the junk food that people eat. Growing up as a teenager, I would consume a bag of Doritos in one sitting, the mega huge packs. And of course, that was way too much sodium. And that can create a problem. And also hidden sodium is monosodium glutamate. So the combination is not good to develop stones, to prevent stones. Here's what you do about it. It's very, very simple. We want to increase our citrates by consuming citric acid from lemon juice, okay? Go to the health food store and get lemon juice. If you can get the organic lemon juice, that would be really, really good. That just has lemon and water. That would be awesome. And you want to consume like 1 to 3 tablespoons of lemon juice in your water throughout the day. Okay, you can do lime juice if you want. And I like to add a teaspoon of apple cider vinegar to that just to put that additional factor into your drink to really help clean out any calcium that builds up. So the combination of lemon and apple cider vinegar with water is really good to prevent and also fix kidney stones if you have them, all right? And then if you have any of these issues too, you might need to fix your stomach. I have videos on how to fix heartburn, and then soft tissue calcium and how to get rid of your sugar cravings. So I have a lot of other videos. So if you found this beneficial, click below and sign up for my weekly email tips, because I give you guys a lot of great tips on fixing a lot of different issues. So I want to thank you, and I will see you in the next video.